Please click the bell icon while subscribing to get my video upload notification. Hey art lovers, today I'm going to show you how I draw anime style scary demonic eyes. I thought it would be a great tutorial for Halloween art. So let's get into it. I am taking a grey background not only because it will give a good support to the colors of the drawing, but also it will help me to create a gloomy look. I took a basic soft brush with shape dynamics control pen pressure on, along with transfer control pen pressure on, to sketch the shapes. Roughly drawing nose and eye positions. Now for the eyes, I'm shaping it in an angle. Also, I generally make the eyes as big as possible. If you like smaller, more sharp looking eyes, then that will work as well. Since it's an angular facial view, I am drawing the eye on the other side, little smaller in size, and then marking the side of her face, adjusting the eye size little bit, roughly drawing the eyebrows. Now I'm going to draw a clean line on top of the rough sketch. If you are a beginner, it's better to have a rough sketch before drawing the final one. But if you're fine with drawing at one go, then do so. Now notice the shape of the eye that I'm drawing here. The upper curve goes upwards right away with a relatively steeper angle, and then have a gradual sliding. On the lower side, the curve starts to go down smoothly, then create deep convex shape before going upward and meet the upper curve. Now this is one of many shapes that we use to draw such eyes, but I find this one really interesting to draw. Similarly, drawing the other eye and then outline the nose. You can check the proportion while drawing by flipping the image once in a while. It will give you a better understanding of the shape. Drawing the irises. I wanted to have them large as it will be most prominent on the face. Also, it would be easier to see the detailing. Another type of iris shape that would look good on scary eyes is an elliptical one, an elongated and thin shaped iris. But for this example, I am taking a big one. Now the main part that will make all the difference, coloring. I want the eyes to be bright, burning and flamboyant. So I started off with filling the eye with yellow color. Now I'm taking the charcoal pencil brush and turn on transfer control pen pressure and start coloring on top of yellow with an orange color. I want the upper part darker than the lower. So I started off with the upper part and start coloring lightly as I go downwards. I'm already marking the area for the pupil. Continue shading with a darker orange, but this time covering lesser area than before. I'm using the charcoal pencil brush because I like the texture it gives. If you like to use something smoother, you can use the basic soft brush. Using the colors, I'm creating a texture in the eye to establish the characteristic of the eye. Following previous examples, I'm using a darker color to shade, defining prominent shadow areas like right below the eyelid, bottom part of the iris, etc. With the red color, I'm enhancing the shade. At this point, I'm giving more definitive shape to the pupil. Using all the colors now to blend them with each other. Took a brown color and start giving more definition. Along with shading, I'm drawing little connecting nerves on the eye with this color. I think my Tolkien influence is kicking in. At this stage, it reminds me of Sauron for some reason. Anyways, you can try different patterns here. It's really fun to do. With a dark brown color and a thin soft brush, I'm defining the pupil, drawing an elongated pupil to give it an unnatural or rather a supernatural look. Drawing more nerves with light strokes. This gives more prominence to the drawing, using other colors to enhance the look as well. Took the yellow color and changed the mode to color dodge and then giving a bit of shine on the eye. Now on a layer with overlay layer mode, I add some black and blur it. Instead of white, I'm adding gray to the sclera, which is the white part on human eye. But I guess it would look a bit gloomy if I give a darker shade there. Then shading with darker colors, giving flesh color to tear duct and conjunctiva area, shading them with darker color and then adding some shine to them. To make the eye more prominent and menacing, I am adding black shade to its upper and lower part and smudge them. Now adding some eyelashes, taking a very light yellow and using it as eye shine. What's an anime eye without its shine? I decided to give thin shine rather than a big circular one. It gives the eye the shiny look it deserves without disturbing the balance of the detailing in it. Now I just cheated and copy pasted the eye on the other side, but that is just to show how they look with a gloomy gray face in this quick tutorial. I would suggest you to draw the other eye as well when you want to do a piece. Giving a quick shading on the nose and rest of the face with a gray color to show the contrast. Then adding some hair. This is more or less how you draw evil looking demonic eye. I would encourage you to experiment with the eye shape as well as shape of the iris and pupil. Different shapes will give you different level of creepiness. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Share this video with other art lovers, anime lovers, and scary stuff lovers. And don't forget to subscribe. Enjoy Halloween. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.